Good morning, everybody. Happy Friday. This is it. End of the week. You get to chill out, get to do something fun. I hope none of you have to work this weekend, right? But this is it. It's Friday. Let's celebrate. Let's have a good time. Let's raise our cup. Have a sip. I made fresh coffee right now. It's delicious. So, anyhow, we are going to talk about what are you asking for. Good morning, Melinda. Nice to see you. Good morning, Andy. I wonder if anybody caught the show last night, if you liked it. Good morning, Laura. Hi. Hi, Rhonda. Hello, everybody. Hi, Kiko. Nice to see you. And Brooklyn. So everybody's coming in. Welcome, welcome, everybody. Good morning, Deanna. Hi, everybody. So it's interesting. I saw this post the other day, and obviously it kind of created this talk today. What are you asking for? See, so many people are stuck in the complaining realm. You know, you're complaining about this, you're complaining about that, you're complaining you don't have enough money or this isn't going right. And thank you. Good. And what you gotta remember is you're asking for it. I know that sounds crazy. Some people say, well, I'm sick and I asked for that, and well, I'm doing this and I asked for that. On some level, yeah. On some level, you know, whether you're dealing with a past life thing and you haven't quite sorted that out, right? Or you've got a block or a belief system. I got to tell you, you know, I'm always, honestly, always looking at going deep, evaluating my own belief systems. You know, you can't get so locked into your belief system, because what will happen is, if you don't have flexibility, if you're not willing to look at your belief system, then you're unable to make it or create change. And you got to look at it. So if you're stuck in a certain area of your life, really take a moment to look at the belief system out there. Let's say you're single and you really want to meet someone, yet you turn around and you say to someone, well, there's no good ones out there. What do you think's going to happen? Wait, you think you're going to now find a good one? No, you're going to go to the world's end to prove yourself right, that there's no good ones left, right? So you have to really look at that perspective, really go deep into what belief systems are you carrying, are you holding, and are they truly in alignment with you? You know, sometimes we have this belief system, but it's actually not in alignment with us. We just kind of adapted it from someone else, or kind of feel like it's the way we're supposed to be, so we hold on to it, but it's not organic. So, good morning, Matthew. Hello. But remembering, you're getting exactly what you're asking for. What you're putting out is what you're getting. You know, and maybe there's a time delay, maybe it's not in the way you wanted it to be, but you know, if you're looking at everything and you say, and that's the other thing, I think people exaggerate, that should be another whole topic by itself. Stop exaggerating. Stop saying, oh, my whole life is crap. Just stop, because there's actually many areas of your life, and the odds of every single area not being well, I don't know. There's got to be something good in one of those areas or something positive. And if you're not willing to kind of be aware of that, then you're really just going to keep manifesting the hole that we're digging, you know? Good morning, Karen. Hi, Michelle. Hello, everybody. So, you know, look at yourself and ask yourself, do I have these belief systems too? Ask yourself right now if you are holding on to any belief systems that really aren't serving you. So show me some hearts if that's you. If you're saying, you know what, I know I've got this. I'm trying to figure it out. I'm trying to work through it. I'm trying to let it go. I just kind of haven't worked through that yet. Because, you know, that's what happens. There we go. I'm seeing some hearts. I love the honesty because it's true. I love it. There you go. Because it's, I do. I believe all of us do. I believe all of us do. So I believe that, because here's the thing, whatever your belief system is right now, right in this here moment, just know that it's supposed to change and evolve anyway. You know, we change, we evolve, we grow, we learn, we experience. So wherever you're at will be changing anyway, if you allow it, if you're flexible to that change. But when you're stuck, you know, and let's look at it from a positive standpoint. Let's say good things are happening. You met someone, or this is good, and you're enjoying things. That good vibration, that good energy, what you're putting out is now being magnified. So it's not all just negative. You can magnify the positive. You can grow your garden of love, and you can grow that garden of money, honey. I'm out there growing. I am. I'm planting a lot of seeds. So looking and being honest about yourself, looking and being honest about what are you putting out, and saying, am I getting what I'm asking for? Because sometimes your words aren't matching the alignment, or vice versa. And you have to just be able to look at that and say, all right, how can I align these two? How can I go deeper? How can I look more into the microscope of where I'm going and what I'm doing and what am I putting out there? But gotta trust, you are literally, I promise you, you are manifesting what you're putting out there. And it's tough. It can get very frustrating. It can get super frustrating when you feel like you're in a hole, when you feel like the wheels are spinning and you feel really stuck. It's, you know, take a moment rather than spin the wheels, you know, like you know, in the mud or whatever, they're just going to keep spinning, right? You're not going to get any traction. So you just have to stop. You have to stop. You have to rethink, you know, do I need to put a piece of wood under those tires? Do I need to get a tow? Do I need to get some help? Do I need to catch an Uber? So looking at, you know, where am I stuck? Where is it not working? What am I putting out for that? What am I manifesting in that? What do I have to change about that block or that belief system or that past life experience? And let go. If you're doing the victim role, you gotta let go of it. You gotta let go of excuses. You gotta let go, this is happening to me. You gotta let go, they're all after me. Gotta let it go, because the universe does not want to see you fail. They don't want to see you fail. All right, your team, your spirit team, they don't want to see you fail. And so when you are feeling like it's all coming down, just take a break, just take a moment, hit the reset button and say, all right, what do I need to change here? What is it I'm thinking, feeling, doing that I need to kind of tweak, reevaluate, readjust, look at, so that I can literally call in what it is I want. And so when those two are matching, I'm in alignment. And it's being clear. You have to be clear on what you want. And very clear. And again, it can't just be, oh, I want more money. We all want more money. It has to be, how do I do it? How do I make that happen? Not like, oh, let me hit the lottery. No, like, figure it out. Figure out the steps that need to happen. Figure out your belief systems around money. Good morning, Dolores. Figure out if you have any blocks, figure out if you're dealing with a past life around it. You know, can't let go of a past life experience if you can't be hypnotized. Oh, I would have to disagree, Jay-Z. Yeah, I'm not sure if I understand that right, but if you're saying, I don't know if you're telling people that they can't let go of a past life experience unless they're hypnotized. I would really have to disagree with that. I mean, otherwise, the hypnotherapist, they would be the millionaires. No, I'm not sure if I'm understanding it right, but I have a massive belief system. We can all go inwards. We can all go within ourselves. The answers are all within us. We can unlock it. We don't need to be hypnotized in order to sort it out. We just need to be quiet and meditate in our own realm, and we can unlock those past life experiences. But that's definitely my take on it, if I'm understanding your question. But yeah, regardless, look at this. None of you need a ton of therapy or a ton of services to kind of get where you want to get. It's really just going inward. It's really tapping into yourself, to your soul, to your higher self to make that connection. And wherever that is, you can unlock whatever it is. If it's a belief system, you have to kind of go back. You have to do the work. And that's the idea. We're depending on all the other people. That's how would you know what that experience is? Well, first of all, why would you depend on a hypnotherapist to tell you what the experience is? I mean, again, you just have to meditate. Jay-Z, if you go inwards and you go quiet to the highest well, to your highest self, you're gonna get all the answers. But if you go start looking to someone else for the answers, you're gonna create more trouble, I think. Anyway, I don't think enough people go inward. And I think when you go inward, when you go inside, and you go into that quiet space, you'll be able to figure it out. I really do. But I don't want to go around telling people they need hypnotherapy to let go past life stuff. Not that I haven't done it. I'm just saying you don't need to. I really don't think you do. So, but hey, again, this is not about past life. This is about you're creating what you're putting out, even in the here and now. And what is that connected to? It could be a belief system you got as a kid. It could be something you grew up with. It could be something you were told as a kid, and so you hang on to it. But you have to give yourself permission. You are allowed to let go. You're allowed to let go of a block. You're allowed to let go of something that's holding you back. You're allowed to let go of a belief system that's no longer serving you. You don't have to hold on to all this baggage, especially if it's not giving you what you want, you know? So there you go. Again, Matthew, here's the deal, everybody. This topic today is not about hypnosis and past lives. Love you all, but you're gonna have to wait for a different topic on a different day. I just don't want to get off track, okay? Because this is important to stay focused on why we're talking about this, and why are we creating the lives we're creating? And if your life is beautiful and abundant and amazing, then you keep rocking it. You keep doing what you're doing. All right, but if it isn't, if there's an area wrong, if there's something not right, if there's something out of sync, even if it's one little area, then just go inwards, look at it, investigate it, open it up, be vulnerable about it so that you can expose it and then you can look at it. And when it's exposed and you look at it, you can decide, do I want to hold on to that? Do I want to keep that? It's kind of like going through your closet when you got a purge. Oh, I love this shirt. Love it. God, I love this shirt. I never wear it, but I really love this shirt. Yeah, the color's not great on you. And you have to decide, do I let go of this shirt? Do I donate it so somebody else can wear it? Or do I just kind of hold on to the into the closet because I don't want to let it go? And at sometimes we got to let things go. Sometimes we got to bring things in. But just know wherever you are and whatever you're doing and whatever is being created for you, you're contributing to it. All right? We got to be responsible for what we're contributing. We got to be responsible for what we're putting in. And exactly, bro. Always stay positive. Staying positive is a big part of it. Absolutely. So, anyhow, that is it. That is our talk of the day. I want you to look at, spend the weekend, all right? Spend the weekend and just notice if, something isn't working for you. Thank you, Megan. Look at if, look at the areas of your life. So the general areas, general. We've got career, we've got health, we've got finances, family, love, relationship, legal. Thank you. And so we have these areas. Those are the general areas. And you've got soul purpose. Love you, Jay-Z. Got soul purpose, all of those things, right? And so look at those areas. Remember, odds are not all of them are down at one time. All right? Odds are if you really look at it, it might be one or two of those. All right? And so what I want you to do is when you catch those one or two, yeah? When you catch them, just ask yourself, see if you're saying something about that. See if you're saying something that is creating a belief system that actually isn't serving really what you want. Just try to catch yourself, kind of catch, just, you know, because the point is it has, we have to bring it into our awareness. The minute you can bring it into your awareness is the minute you can then release it. All right. So there you go. I want you to have a gorgeous weekend, a beautiful weekend. Enjoy. And Monday is our 200th episode. 200. So make sure you dial in. You're going to have to tune in. Everybody's going to have to play in the sandbox on Monday. Okay. All right. Love you guys. Talk to you later. Bye.